Hello and welcome. Today I'll be showing you some ways to make some pixel art parallax backgrounds for your games and other projects. So what is a parallax background? Well, if you look out the window of a car, you'll notice that things further away look smaller and things closer to you look bigger. We call this perspective, and perspective is a very important aspect of any art medium. For example, these two houses are the same size, but in our image they look different. In house B, I used less pixels to create it because it was further away and therefore appeared smaller. So, what does that have to do with parallax? Well, have you ever been in a car, driving somewhere out in the open and noticed that faraway objects look like they're staying still, but objects close to you are moving really fast? This is what we call the parallax effect. Objects further away appear to be moving slower than objects closer to you, when in actual fact, they aren't. This is because the object further away takes longer to pass through your field of vision due to your view's triangular shape. We can put this idea of parallax into a game design context. If your character moves, you want the background to move with it. Alright, well, that looks cool, but something about that seems off. It looks like an image stuck on a wall behind our character instead of a vast landscape. To fix this, we need to add some parallax. What we'll do is divide the background into layers and change the individual speed of each. Much better. Now our scene actually has some depth and feels a bit more realistic. But let's take it back a step first. We want to know how to draw these background images, so let's get into it. I always like to start with the section that's closest in front and work my way back, but of course, it's up to you. Now, the most important thing to remember here is that the section should be the same on both sides so they match up when put next to each other. Let's begin by drawing a solid rectangle to ensure the height is the same for both sides. Now, we'll want to customize this rectangle and make it into a background. Backgrounds are such an open-ended topic and you can really make whatever you want here. Unfortunately, in this video, I won't be going over all of them because the video would get way too long. I'm making a desert, so I've turned this rectangle into something a little rockier. The main thing to remember here is to add some changes in elevation and not make your section completely flat. Notice how the edges are the same height. And to make your colors line up, you can copy the vertical line of pixels on the very edge of your drawing and paste them to the opposite side. Now, some details. If you're doing a street, some power poles, signs, fences, and other urban objects would work well. But for me, I made some cacti. And I think we're ready for stage 2. If your program has layers, that's awesome. Go ahead and add a new layer. If you don't have layers, that's okay too. Just move to another section of your page. For this section, it's the same process as the first. Just remember, we want it a little taller than our first one so we can see it behind that front layer. As a general rule, I like to change the brightness of my sections as they go along. Here I'm making every section a bit lighter than the last. Now customize, but remember the objects will be smaller at this stage. If I were to have some cacti at this layer, I would make them smaller than they appear on the first layer. And then it's really just a matter of repeating this for each stage. I'm only doing 3 stages, but you can choose how many layers you want. For the very background, make a sky or whatever suits your game. Make the size of the background cover the entire height of the screen. And remember, this won't move, or at least, not very much. Here are the 4 layers we just made. But of course, you'll need to add in the objects that the player interacts with. So here I've made a rocky ground. Putting it all together now, we can see that the background looks a lot more 3-dimensional with their individual layers. And that's our basic parallax background. Something I like to do is to make some silhouettes of clouds in white, and then add them between the layers. If you lower the opacity, it will further help your impression of depth because the objects behind the translucent clouds will be fainter. Just remember to make the height the same on both sides. This is what it looks like without the clouds, and this is what it looks like with the clouds. So not really much of a difference, but I like to add it anyway. I think it gives it more atmosphere and a little more depth. So now that we've made a desert parallax background, we can experiment with some other themes. There's really unlimited possibilities for different backgrounds. For example, a pretty common one I've seen for jungles and forests is to draw something similar to this. On the first layer, you have the shrubs and bushes at the bottom, and the tree leaves at the top. This gives you a vignette effect and forces the viewer to focus on the middle of the screen. Then, you just work your way down the sections and repeat the process in lighter shades. The second example was actually inspired by a game Broforce, which is a very nice looking forest setting for some of the game. In this example, I've made a train riding through the landscape. On the front layer, we have the train and the tracks, followed by some trees behind it. On the third layer, at a slightly different speed, I drew in some power poles. Finally, I added a couple of layers of trees in the background. The last version is a cave background. The way I built up the parallax for this version was by separating the top and bottom rocks into individual layers. This way it looks like the back wall of the cave is really far away. So you can see that this idea of a parallax background can be pretty much anything you like. As long as you separate the layers and make the speed of the back layer the slowest, your backgrounds will look great. And you don't have to limit parallax backgrounds to horizontal movement either. If you want your games to be more immersive, you can make the background move and the character jumps. Parallax doesn't even have to be limited to games. You can use it in websites, apps, and other things too. Here, I've made a couple of examples. The first is a website, where I use the jungle background to provide some visual interest behind the company logo. This adds another layer of complexity to the website. For this next example, I made use of the way people scroll to view websites on phones. By implementing some vertical movement, the scene appears to be 3D because it responds to the scroll. You can see that this effect is really useful and can have many applications. If you like these tutorial style videos, and you want to learn more pixel art techniques, then hit that subscribe button because I should be making some more tutorials soon. If you don't like these videos, then don't subscribe because there's no point watching if you don't want to. Thanks for watching and hopefully you learned something today. See you in the next video.